So we know that historically this community faces a lot of challenges. You know, when you look at the maps of the COVID data, it's very similar to maps around high rates of diabetes, high rates of unemployment and poverty, and all of those things contribute to poor health, unfortunately.
A pop-up COVID-19 testing site has finally arrived at the Christian Center Church near Jane and Steeles, a welcome site for community members and health experts who have long been urging the province for support amid a pandemic that has disproportionately affected them.
I was very happy because it's very close to us, for us to be able to come and have the test and for us to know if we have it or not.
A big difference, because I'm close nearby, and that's the main priority for me. And for me to be safe, and the client to be safe, and my family to be safe.
The numbers here in our community are pretty bad in terms of the percentage of those who have COVID versus the rest of the city.
We crunched the numbers, and according to the city's latest data, Black Creek residents are almost 19 times more likely to get the virus than residents in the Beaches, who have the lowest infection rate.
This is a community that has to travel great distances to work, so exposing themselves on TTC. We have community members who are working jobs, such as, you know, their PSWs or in different factory industries, and that also puts them at greater risk for exposure. We also know that COVID is disproportionately affecting our Black communities, and this is a very, ethnically and culturally diverse community.
The top three neighborhoods with the highest rate of infection: Weston, Humber Heights Westmount, and Glenfield Jane Heights. The hardest hit neighborhoods are mainly clustered in Toronto's northwest region and have a high proportion of Black and visible minority residents. Health officials are hoping the mobile site near Jane and Steeles will help them get a better grasp on the virus's spread and an understanding of what resources are needed most. But which neighborhoods the program would expand to, the province would not confirm, only saying in a statement, "Decisions about mobile units are informed by a variety of inputs, including data showing where specifically there is a high prevalence of cases and public health information related to contact tracing and case management." In the meantime, community organizers are encouraging everyone in the Black Creek area to get tested. Weston says some may feel uncomfortable with the process, so we decided to show you what it's like.
First of all, make sure you have your health card with you. When you arrive, no appointment necessary. You're going to come and sign in here. So once you're done your paperwork, you're led into the gymnasium here. We're going to head over to the next desk here, number 4, and this is where they're going to ascribe the information on the individual test. So now I have my information on the individual vial here, and we're going to head over and get tested.
Your eyes for me. Tilt your head. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All done.
Wow.
You handled that like a champ.
Thank you very much. That was actually pretty quick. It wasn't, painful, a little uncomfortable. If you didn't get a chance to come by today, the testing site here at the Christian Center will also be open on Wednesday and Friday from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. And also for anyone in Brampton, there will be a pop-up testing site there at the Brampton Curling Club, and that will open on Wednesday at 10 a.m. In North York, Erica Natividad, City News.